A very good morning to you. Happy Wednesday, the sixth day of October. My name is Jessica Ramir, a senior market analyst with Bell Direct. But the Aussie share market is to nudge up and extend this week's rise of 0.9%. Stocks will be rebound, but caution remains as debts swell. And uranium stocks, they're supported high with expectations production will double by 2050. But now to overseas markets. The major US indices rebounded in the US overnight, led by investors buying the dip into tech stocks. The NASDAQ up 1.3%. The Dow Jones, remember that's the biggest 30 stocks in the US. Well, the Dow Jones rose 1.1%. Now, despite tech and oil stocks charging overnight, there's still a lot of uncertainty keeping markets from rebounding back to their all-time highs. So what is the uncertainty? Firstly, the world is awaiting to learn the fate of China's biggest property developer, Evergrande, which remains in a trading halt. Also, there's another large Chinese property developer, Fantasia, which missed a debt repayment, which means iron ore demand is likely to slow down even further. The second reason for uncertainty, the US debt ceiling needs to be reviewed by October 18. So the debt ceiling needs to be raised or suspended, or the US risks their first ever default of national debt. So that's a huge cloud hanging over equities. But regardless, what to watch today? Three key areas. Firstly, the futures are suggesting that our Aussie market will lift 0.5% with the risk on flick being switched back on. The focus will be on tech and oil stocks, of course. Secondly, with that in mind, let's check in with commodities. The oil price is now at $78.93 US. That's the oil price's highest level since 2014. Also, remember, oil prices are up 50% this year. So this is adding a lot to inflationary pressures for consumers. Most of the other commodities are trading lower, except uranium, which trades higher. It's worth noting the International Atomic Energy Agency expects world nuclear generating capacity to double by 2050 as the world moves away from fossil fuels to fight climate change. So with that in mind, I'd be keeping an eye on uranium stocks today, like Paladin, PDN, and Deep Yellow, DYL. Also keep in mind, there are only four uranium companies with licenses to mine in South Australia. They include Energy Resources of Australia, ERA. They're majority owned by Rio Tinto. You've also got Alliance Resources, AGS, Boss Energy, BOE, and of course, the heavyweight, BHP. You all know their ticker code, BHP. The third area to watch today, although there's no economic news out, it's worth reflecting on what happened yesterday or what we learned yesterday. Australia's balance of trade, remember, exports minus imports, that hit a record all-time high. But if you dived into the detail, there was actually lower than expected iron ore sales to China in August compared to July. So that spooked investors in iron ore because it means cash flow and revenue for iron ore stocks would have decreased over that period from August to July. Also yesterday, the RBA reconfirmed it will continue to buy bonds to support the corporate world in Australia and the economy till February next year. So that's good. The RBA stuck to their knitting as they were expected to do that. As for trading ideas, here's a couple worth a look. Citi increased their buy rating for baby retailer Baby Bunting BBN, increasing their price target to $6.11, implying 13% share price growth in a year. Why? Well, recently Baby Bunting's AGM revealed that sales has accelerated following Baby Bunting's last trading update. And Citi, the investment bank, thinks that sales will continue to accelerate through the rest of the year, particularly because lockdowns are ending. The company is also making faster than expected progress towards building their own private label. And this will result in strong gross margins, meaning profit. And that's also been better than expected to date. Another trading idea, Citi increased its buy rating for Nick Scali, NCK, and fluffed up the pillows, increasing the price target for the furniture business to $16.80. Other trading ideas that could be worth a look, Bullish charting signals have been seen in Silver Lake Resources, SLR, Callium Lakes, KLL, and Team Invest Private Group, TIP. That's according to Trading Central. I'm Jessica Ramirez with Bell Direct. Stay safe. Happy trading.